All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Chase Edgelow. He is the CEO of EverGen Infrastructure Corp. And Chase, it's good to have you back again. How are you?
Great. I'm great. Thanks, Steve. Thanks for having us.
Yeah, super big announcement out from the company today that you secured $31 million in a loan, and that will, in essence, fuel your upgrades and expansion. We'll talk about it in just a second. But first, why the loan route, Chase?
Yeah, so this is always part of our corporate strategy is to, you know, have a certain amount of debt in our capital structure. We've raised $60 million of equity to date, and $30 million of debt, I think, is still really conservative leverage for the projects that we build, the infrastructure style projects that we build. We think over time, there's going to be capacity for, you know, well north of 50% leverage on these assets. So continuing to build in a way that's accretive for our shareholders, and at the same time, taking minimal risk.
Yeah. So it obviously puts a big treasury into play now. And I know there's a bunch of things that you want to do. First off, let's talk about the Fraser Valley Biogas expansion project, because that's a key one. You're going to use about $15 million for that. Can you sort of tell us what it is the expansion plan looks like?
So Fraser Valley Biogas is a facility that's been producing into Fortis's network for about a decade now. And, you know, with the advances in technology and systems, we're going to be doubling the capacity of that facility with our construction and improving reliability. And at the same time, you know, one of the benefits of the current market is that gas prices are significantly higher. So we're getting paid a premium, looking to enter into a new contract for our RNG sales at that facility. And we'll be breaking ground in September with additional gas volumes coming on in Q1 of 2023. So this is really, it's a near-term project. It's a chance for us to demonstrate our operational capabilities and the ability to turn around projects that are existing, but you really have that upside built into them.
Okay. And the rest of it will be used towards the Abbotsford RNG expansion project. Can you talk a bit about that one as well?
Yeah. So Net Zero Waste Abbotsford, you know, for us today is an organics processing facility. And we've got a 20-year offtake agreement with Fortis at that site to bring in the RNG capture infrastructure that's needed. The Abbotsford region, you know, for many of those that were impacted by the floods, you know, would understand what had significant infrastructure damage. So we're in the process of awaiting building and permitting approvals alongside a number of other parties that are all rebuilding post-flood. So that project is essentially ready to go. We're working through our permitting. We expect to be able to break ground on that project in the next 12 months. And we're doing everything in our power to try and expedite that timeline. But the project itself is, you know, it's got the things that we look for. It's got an offtake agreement secured. It's got feedstock coming to the facility. It's got an existing footprint that we can build and expand on top of. And it's in a jurisdiction where you get the benefit of selling green energy. And at the same time, you've also got a significant place to take the organic fertilizer post-process. So the side benefit of our projects is that we produce a significant volume of organic fertilizer that can be used by the agricultural community.
Last question, Chase, then, is Fraser Valley Biogas and Net Zero Abbotsford obviously getting a major influx of cash and some major upgrades. Where does this put the company now as far as being able to compete with everyone who's in your sector and really compete here in British Columbia?
Yeah, so this injection of capital plus our existing balance sheet and our existing cash flow gives us direct line of sight, fully funded projects that will take us to north of $13 million EBITDA. And that's just our core expansion projects. Beyond that, we've got development projects, including Project Radius in Ontario, which is a significant increase to our pipeline, and then other projects that we've been working with developers on. So we continue to grow the platform. This gives us a direct line of sight to the 420,000 gigajoules of production that we'll have coming from our three facilities in Western Canada, but we continue to maintain our footprint across the country and in all of the key jurisdictions where you've got an organic waste problem and you've got a need for green energy.
All right, we'll leave it there. Chase, congratulations on this. Exciting times for you and the company ahead, and we look forward to following that story as well. So nice to see you again. Thank you.
Great. Thanks, Steve.
All right, there's Chase Edgelow. He's the CEO of EverGen Infrastructure Corp.